I think one of the first questions we're going to be asking is whether threat intelligence is actually necessary or attribution is necessary. Does it make any difference if we know who's attacking us?
$10 billion, by far the biggest cyber attack in history.
Within 15 minutes, their entire environment was taken down.
The thing that really amazed me were how many corollaries were being drawn from the military.
I've worked very, very closely with CISOs over the last 2-3 years, and the challenges they face are amazing.
We kind of just touched the surface. There is so much more to this conversation.
My name is Naveen Vasudeva. I believe that the field in which I work is misunderstood by the public or deemed too technically focused for some. It is really important to start shining a light on how businesses and technology suppliers can work in a much more collaborative manner to help solve some of the problems that we face as an industry. In my opinion, there is a general disconnect between security leadership, business leadership, and the vendor community. I teamed up with Tony Morbin, the former editor-in-chief for Haymarket Media Group. Tony and I agreed that it was time to start challenging that status quo and dive into some of these topics with industry and technology vendors.
Tony, organizations need to be intelligence-led. And in cybersecurity, we talk about threat intelligence. What's your viewpoint on threat intelligence?
I think one of the first questions we're going to be asking is whether threat intelligence is actually necessary or attribution is necessary. Does it make any difference if we know who's attacking us? But I think even before that, we need to define what are we talking about when we're talking about threat intelligence.
So when it comes to threat intelligence, the first thing we always want to do is to understand that we're talking about the same thing. The term itself can mean quite a number of different things to different people.
Threat intelligence originally was around finding IP addresses, finding IOCs, right, so indicators of compromise, helping to share information around how perhaps my company had experienced an attack or how others had experienced an attack, and then looking for those indicators.
We try to break threat intelligence down into 4 main categories. It's operational, tactical, technical, and strategic. These should all be really utilized at different levels of a security strategy.
The operational, and that's where we look for tools, techniques, and processes. So that's much more adversarial oriented. The tactical level, so that's things like indicators of compromise, it's known IP addresses or hashes of files that are known to be malicious. The third thing is strategic, so that's how we link it all back to risk.
How would I define threat intelligence? Is essentially data that provides you with information about threats. It is information that you can use to help defend your organization. Whether it's to detect stuff that's inside your organization already, to improve your detection capabilities, or to future-proof yourself from potential attacks.
And Kevin, you've got such a vast array of information being thrown at you. What defines the threat intelligence over just information?
We can talk on the one hand about technical markers, logs, indicators of compromise. You can buy those feeds. But on the other hand, you're then talking much more at the, shall I say, the strategic and the operational level rather than the tactical level, when you're starting talking about specific threat actors. So who is targeting an industry or a sector? What tools, techniques, processes are they using? Can you then integrate that into your security operations centers to look more or less for specifics?
What is threat intelligence and why is it different from just data and logs? What makes it actionable intelligence?
Actionable intelligence is where you get something that relates directly either to vulnerabilities that you know you might have, threats that are out there that are relatable to either your industry or the type of services that you run, and then you tie that into information that allows you to take action with the controls that you have, so the security measures that you have in your environment.
Whenever you find out that information, sort of what can you do about it, is being able to look at how is it applicable back into my company. Is it applicable to certain services, again, to certain parts of the company, or certain ways that we might be operating, or even against certain information, intellectual property, or ongoing conversations that we're having? And so to me, it really highlights the fact that as security individuals and as CISOs in companies, we've got to have that understanding of the business itself. You know, it's a priority that we understand what is the mandate of the business, you know, how does the business make its money, what makes it successful, what makes it a target, and then being able to map that back to the chatter to be able to prioritize and then drill down and work with controls as needed.
In the past, threat intelligence was really only the luxury of large enterprises, SOCs, certs, that kind of level of organization. And really, they were only people that really needed it because the threat actors of this kind of level were only going after those organizations. Now we're starting to see a bleeding of the lines where more organizations, even at a kind of mid to high SMB, can fall victim to high profile APT attacks or maybe as collateral damage, maybe as a side victim, stepping stone attack. So the necessity for them to introduce threat intelligence become important. The problem is with that is they don't always have the budgets and resources to actively maintain threat intelligence and use it effectively.